Good evening, everyone. Good evening and God bless you. And welcome, welcome, welcome to Beacons for Christ Ministry UK. We are just absolutely thrilled, happy, ecstatic that you have chosen this place to worship and to honor our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We thank you and we warmly welcome you into the fellowship for today as we exalt the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We want to give reverence to our covering pastor, Dr. Maria Seaman from Swim Ministry in Bermuda. God bless her in the name of Jesus. We want to give honor and reverence to our presiding pastor, Pastor Randy Lightbourne. Amen. As we look forward to the word today and pray for God's continued covering and anointing on him. And we want to give reverence and honor to our beautiful First Lady and all of her support of our pastor, and that's Reverend Eunice Lightbourne. God bless you. We greet you all in the name of Jesus as we are excited to start this service today. Welcome. And let us worship our Lord and Savior in spirit and in truth. Amen. We're going to go straight into our opening song, God is Here. That's our affirmation. Hallelujah. God is here in this atmosphere, taking over this environment and this space. Let's sing this song to the honor and glory of God in Jesus' name. At the closing of this song, we will invite our IT Stacy to do the opening prayer. Amen.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord God, we just come to you this day, oh God, thanking you for the breath that we breathe, oh God. Thanking you for your mercy and your grace that kept us, oh God, that we can be able to come and offer our praise and our worship, offer our hearts to you, oh God, as we sit under the teaching that you have prepared your manservant to deliver to us. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We praise you, oh God, for you are worthy of all praise, honor, and glory. Lord, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Father, I rejoice, oh God, knowing that, Lord, I can sit under sound teaching, oh God. So, Father, I commit this service to you, oh God. All the scriptures that will be read, oh God, may they pierce our hearts, oh God. May they find good soil, oh God. All the teaching, oh God, that we hear, oh God, let us incline our ears to listen, oh God. I pray in the name of Jesus for our pastor. Even now, oh God, Lord, as you have poured this message into him, oh God, may he deliver it with boldness. May he deliver it with clarity, oh God. May, Father God, our hearts, oh God, be aligned to the word, oh God, that you will pour into him, oh God. I pray that the Holy Spirit have his way, oh God, in this place, oh God, in each heart. Lord, those that will listen now, oh God, and later, oh God, on social media, Lord, we just believe that you will be glorified in all these things. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, thanking you. Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, R.I.T. Stacy, for opening us up into this wonderful praise and worship, this service today. We thank you for that, and we receive the fullness of your prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. May it hit the ground with authority. Amen. Praise God. We invite Brother Roger at this time to do the scripture reading. Amen.
Amen. Here begins the reading of the word. 2 Kings chapter 20, verses 1 to 6. 2 Kings chapter 20, verses 1 to 4. In those days was Hezekiah sick unto death, and the prophet Isaiah the son of Amos came to him and said unto him, thus says the Lord, set thine house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Then he turned his face to the wall and prayed unto the Lord, saying, I beseech thee, O Lord, remember how I have walked before thee in truth and with a perfect heart, and have done that which is good in thy sight. And Hezekiah wept sore. And it came to pass, afore Isaiah was going out into the middle court, that the word of the Lord came to him, saying, turn again and tell Hezekiah, the captain of my people, thus says the Lord, the God of David, thy father, I have heard thy prayer. I have seen thy tears. Behold, I will heal thee on the third day. Thou shalt go up unto the house of the Lord, and I will add unto thy days 15 years. I will deliver thee and this city out of the hand of the king of Assyria, and I will defend the city of mine, my own sake, and for my servant David's sake. May God's word add a blessing to the reading of his holy word. Amen.
Amen. Praise God indeed. Thank you, Brother Roger, for that powerful reading of the holy word. Amen. To which we look forward with great anticipation to find out what God has poured into our pastor for us for today's service. Amen. Praise God. That's jump right into our praise and worship service at this time. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Let's get some worship on in this place. Amen.
Glory, glory, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, glory, glory, much glory, much hallelujah, since we have the power and the authority and the permission of our Savior and Lord to bring it to him and lay our burdens down. What a beautiful, empowering way to praise and exalt God together. Amen. Let's go straight into our next song, Total Praise. Hallelujah. And that's what we want to give him today. Glory. We want to give him total praise. Hallelujah. This atmosphere is for the glory and honor of God in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Let's sing this to the honor and glory of God. Song. Oh, I got completely lost just now. What a beautiful, empowering song, just giving all that praise and worship to our Heavenly Father. At this time, we are just going to get ourselves ready to receive the word. We have a beautiful sermonic song that we're going to sing together in oneness for the glory of God. This song is I'm Going to Be Ready. Hallelujah. I'm going to be ready. Let's sing this song to the honor and glory of God, this beautiful sermonic song, as we prepare our space, blocking everything out to receive the word of God. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Say a prayer every night. Whatever I do, I'll get it right. With no regret, no guilt or shame. This time, no, not this time. Once I surrender, I won't dare look back. 'Cause if I do, I'll get off track. Move ahead in faith and patiently await your answer. What will it be?
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, everyone. I'm giving honor and glory to God for this wonderful opportunity for us to be together once again, to be fellowshipping, to be in each other's presence as we stand before God and as we seek to be of an encouragement to each other. It's exciting, especially as we sing these songs and these hymns of praise to God. And we realize how blessed we really are. Praise the Lord. Let me go straight into prayer. Lord, I lift my hands to you, God, and I say thank you, God. All honor to you, all glory, all praise, Lord God. Father God, I want to be what you would have me to be. So I bring myself before you, asking that you would move aside anything that would be of a distraction so that your Holy Spirit can have free reign in my life. God, order my steps, Lord God. And use me for your honor and glory. Bring forward your word with clarity and conviction. And may your name be praised from my lips. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. It's such a beautiful opportunity to bring forward a fresh word from God. A fresh opportunity. Every time the word of God is given, one of the primary things that you want to do is to self-examine, to see how it applies specifically to me and how I can apply it in my everyday life. And I pray today as we look at this topic that God has gave me, and as I bring forward this word, that that's what you do in the next days and the weeks and the months of this year. Continue to remember that this is a self-examining process in this walk we have with God. So when the word is given, we look at how we can apply it to our lives and be realistic of where we are at, not looking at someone else or what somebody else is doing and what someone else is achieving or not achieving, but we want to apply it to ourselves and to see what God is saying to me today. Praise the Lord.